Hello guys, my name is X1 Gamer and this is my next review of Descent of Dragons cards for the next expansion of Hearthstone that will be released December 10, 2019. So without losing any of your time, let's start talking about the cards that was revealed in the last 2 days. The first one is a pretty mediocre one. Just one mana, 1/2 hot air balloon. At the start of your turn, gain +1 health. It's a mech, so that's probably kind of important. So how good is this? I think this is pretty very nice one drop minion, because it's like at minimum it's one mana 1/2. If this survive, will became 1 mana 1/3. How often is this to survive? I don't know. So I think this is pretty fair card. It's nothing too special, but maybe when every other mech is rotated out next year to 2020, maybe this will see some play. But until then, I think there is a better solution to play something on round one, at least now. So let's move to the next card. So next card, we have kind of unusual one for me. I'm a little bit surprised, to be honest with you. This is a neutral 6 mana 6/6 mech. Camouflaged dirigible. Battle cry, give your other mechs stealth until your next turn. So I don't see much application in this card. Maybe if you play some kind of a very very aggressive token deck, and you also zoo deck with mechs, so you can fill the board with small minions, and then for example play something like buffs with Druid, because Druid have lots of buffs on the board that can buff small minions. Also, the other application that I see that can work with this card is Bloodlust in Shaman. So I think this card can see some play. It's some ridiculously mindless aggressive deck, but in my opinion, it's a very very mediocre card, and I don't like it personally, because it's just support stupid mindless aggro decks that I personally didn't like. So how good is this card? It's pretty mediocre card. It's pretty fair, so it's okay. Let's move to the next one. Next one, we have a legendary neutral minion, 7 mana 1/7, Shuma. At the end of your turn, fill your board with 1/1 tentacles. That's pretty strong, even that it looks like super. It's super mediocre. Actually, it's not. It looks better than it actually is. Actually, it's better than its look, because back in the day when we played Dr. Boom on round 7, we know how annoying it is to deal with small minions. But this is even more annoying, because it fills your entire board. In which archetype this card can see benefits and synergy? Most probably with in some decks that have lots of synergy with spells, buffs. Like the previous one, for example, you can play this, and if your opponent didn't remove it immediately, you can have presence on board. If he didn't play board clear, and next round you can kill it with Bloodlust or some kind of other mechanics. The good part of this card is that it's neutral, so it can see play in literally every single deck out there. So I think this card is pretty strong. It's look very dangerous. It's very very powerful. So I think this card will definitely see some play, because this is at least 7 mana 16 or something. Because it's 7 mana 13. It's actually, yeah, something like this. 7 mana 8/13. So it's pretty good by itself. So I think this card will definitely see some play. So let's move to the next one. Next one is absolutely crazy one. This is one of the most powerful card that I see in Hearthstone. Neutral legendary card in Hearthstone in the last few expansions. So let's read. So it's a neutral legendary minion, Kronk's Dragonhoof, 6 mana 6/6. Battle cry, draw Galakrond. If you are already Galakrond, unleash a devastation. That's absolutely insane, guys. That's absolutely insane. So you will ask, What is devastation? Well, let's look at devastation. So this is devastation card number one, reanimation. Summon 8-8 dragon with taunt. So basically it means that it's absolutely crazy stats on board. You have a 6-6 from Kronks and another 8-8 with taunt for free, which is absolutely crazy. The condition is that you need to have you need to be Galakrond to activate this effect. How hard is this? How hard is this to happen? Not very hard, because a lot of classes have mechanics to bounce back the cards. For example, like Priest, Rogue, of course, and a few others with neutral cards, of course. Also, you can back bounce these cards, card and plate, once again when you are already Galakrond. So how good is this? Absolutely crazy. This is next level crazy. It's very, very powerful. It's in the middle of the game. It's round 6. This is like 6 mana, so it can be played on round 6. Even when you play it on round 6 and you don't have Galakrond, you mean that you will draw Galakrond from your deck and you will have ridiculously powerful turn next round. So this card is beyond ridiculous. It's super powerful, super OP in my opinion. It's 5 out of 5 stars all over the place. It's just crazy. So let's look at the next devastation. So what's the next devastation? Next devastation is domination. Give your other minions +2/+2. Well, I didn't find this one too powerful, but it's still okay if you have already established port and you want to keep your presence on board and trade minions if your opponent is not close to dead, so you don't want to directly go face. So it's pretty much okay. So also it's if you have enough minions, also you can use it as finisher. Why not? If your opponent is like, for example, on 10, 12 or 15 health, because 15 health is nothing these days. So it's absolutely insane. Let's move to the next word, decimation. Deal 5 damage. Deal 5 damage to the enemy hero. Restore 5 to your hero. Yeah, this also can be used like finisher. Also, it's it can heal yourself, which is absolutely great, because sometimes when you play against extremely aggressive decks, sometimes you need this kind of a small boost of health so you can survive the next few rounds and just close the game, take control, and turn over the events of the entire game. So let's move to the next and final one. Final one is annihilation. Deal 5 damage to all other minions. So I'm not very sure how exactly this will work here, but I think that it will not affect Kronks itself, which is absolutely amazing. Basically what you have is a 6 mana clear the board and left 6 body on board, 6-6 body on board. Is that good? No, it's not good. That's crazy. That's OP as hell, because this is not a class card, guys. This is neutral legendary minion. This is a minion that I will craft immediately after the expansion is released if I didn't get it into my collection, because like you know, every single Galakrond card will be for free. Every single Galakrond card will be for free. So don't forget to tune in into Hearthstone Descent of Dragons release day so you can get your copy of your free Galakrond cards. All 5 of them. 5 evil classes, 5 dragon Galakronds will be yours. So I don't see why you should not craft this card right away. It's potential. It's a card that potentially can be nerfed at some point. It's very, very, very possible. So this is so safe craft that it's beyond ridiculous. So obviously a very, very strong card, insane power level, very scary. I'm very scared of this card, so I can't wait to play and see the power of this card. So let's move to the next one. Next one we have Hunter legendary minion, 6 mana, 7-6 dragon. That's pretty good stats. It's like vanilla stats in my opinion. So what is the battle cry? Battle cry change the health of all enemy minions to 1. So how good is this? It's pretty okay. It's nothing too special because we already have this type of effect in Paladin, and it's not very often played today because it's way too expensive. It costs like 4 mana, and basically by itself it do absolutely nothing. So you need to have something more to clear the board from danger. So how can this be combat? It's a 9 mana combo with Unleash the Hounds. So if your opponent have like 4 or 5 minions, that is very very dangerous. You can play this and play Unleash the Hounds and clear the board. But I don't know how good is this, because Hunter now have a better solution for clearing the board before round 9. This is with the Venomizer and Rocket Launcher. So, but they will rotate out soon. So is that will be a viable board clear? I don't see it, because just because it's way too slow and it's 2 card. But let's not forget that Hunter have a small rush minion cards that can help clearing the board. So yeah, I think this card is pretty okay. It's nothing too special, but don't forget it's a dragon, so it will have synergy with other dragons and will be interesting to play. So it's a good card, nothing too special, nothing too crazy, but a decent card nonetheless. So let's move to the next one. Oh, actually this is the last one. So this is every single card that I want to reveal today. So yeah guys, that's everything. I hope you enjoy this review. Sorry for my bad English. It's not my natural language, so I want to apologize like always. And also like always, don't forget to check my other videos of Descent of Dragons expansions. So take care, be well, and I see you guys in the next one.